Okay, let's see. Okay, I think we are good to go. So welcome everyone to our next presentation and our next presenter, Benno Blanc. I hope I am saying your name correctly. He is a jazz developer with Auslandia, a French company that you most probably heard of, an open source company offering GIS services, especially for PostGIS and QGIS. And they worked remotely before it was cool. So without any further ado, I will let Benno talk to us about the official web application of QGIS. So you have the floor.
Yeah, thank you, Kadrina. So let's go. Hello, everyone. My name is Benoît Blanc. I'm working at Auslandia since 1 year, especially on QGIS Web Client, which is the purpose of this talk. Before starting, you can find some presentations that have been done by Pierre-Mine Kalberer from SourcePol for the PhosphorG 2019, and my presentation for the QGIS Swiss user group last year. So what is a QGIS Web Client? It's a web mapping application to publish QGIS projects on the web thanks to QGIS server. It's a responsive application, so you can use it on desktop or on mobile. And it is quite modular, as it allows you a wide range of customization possibilities. And you can choose almost all of the features you want in your application. And you can also define your own style in the application. Regarding the technologies used, it is based on the React framework and the Redux. And it uses OpenLayers library for the mapping capabilities. So here is a simple overview of the application. You can see the QGIS project that I have configured in QGIS desktop. So I have the same rendering here in my QGIS web client application. For the context, there was a first version that has been developed until 2017, but it was not responsive and it was more complex than the second version of QGIS Web Client. And now there are up-to-date technologies that are used in QGIS Web Client 2. So what do you need to deploy QGIS Web Client on your server? Basically, you will need QGIS server and a web server, for example, Nginx, and a QGIS web client application built with Yarn. Also, you will have some data and a QGIS project that you will copy to the server. Then QGIS server will serve your QGIS projects as WMS services to the web server. And then you have your data displayed in your application depending on the request that the user send from the client side. So here is the simplest configuration of a QGIS web client. And it allows you to see your QGIS projects on the web. At Auslandia, we choose to use QGIS Web Client because it is based on QGIS server. So we have experience on QGIS server and on QGIS desktop. Also, it has the same rendering as in QGIS desktop. So what you see in QGIS desktop is what you get in QGIS server and in your QGIS Web Client application. Also, as I said before, it is a modular application. So you can configure all the features you want in your application, whether it is a React plugin for the basic features or microservices on the server side, which I will talk about later. So now I'm gonna show you some of the basic features that you can find in the QGIS subclient application without server components. So you have a project browser where you can switch between all the QGIS projects you have deployed in the application. Also, there is a classic layer tree to show or hide the layers you want. You can change the transparency for each layer. You can zoom to a layer, and you can also import an external layer from a local file from WMS or WFS services. You can query objects by clicking on them on the map, and you will find the values of each attribute in the feature info window. In your QGIS project, you can choose to expose or not all the attributes of your layers in the layer properties and in the fields tab. Also, you can change the name of the attribute that will be displayed here in the feature info of my QGIS Web Client application. So you have to set it up in the attributes form of your layer properties. Here, I have also created a virtual attribute with an expression that you can retrieve here, which allow me to display an image in the feature info window. Then, when you have a layout saved in your QGIS project, you can print it in a QGIS web client with a get print request to QGIS server. You can also add a custom text depending on what you write in the text field here. And you can now see the result of my printout with the same rendering as in the layout I have configured in my QGIS project. So here you can retrieve the custom text that I had here. And there are other features in QGIS Web Client, such as configurable providers, measurement tools, redlining functionalities, permalink generations, raster export, import, and map comparison tool, and so on. So once you have the application deployed, you can also choose to add some server-side components to extend the basic features that we have seen until now. And all these services are available in this GitHub repository. Almost all of these services are in Python and use a Flask framework. You can choose to deploy these services as Docker containers or as WSGI services. And once again, it is modular, so you can pick one of these services that according to your needs for your application. What are the additional features for these server-side components? For example, you can log in to the application. You can give some access or restrictions to projects for users with access control. You have also an administration panel to manage users, groups, roles, resources, and permissions. You can also edit data directly in your database. You have also 8 profiles. You can generate permalinks and other features. So here is an example of data edition on a layer. You can pick an object in your layer and edit the geometry and the attributes, or you can also create a new object in your layer that will be saved directly in your database. And here you can measure a distance by drawing a line, and you have the 8 profile that appears in the bottom of the application along the line. And this eight profile is based on the digital elevation model that you want. To give you an example of what you can do with microservices, if you want to give access to QGIS projects only to some users, you will need to deploy several services that will answer to your need. First, you have a service to authenticate to the application. You have also an administration panel to manage users, groups, roles, permissions, and resources. You have a service that works as a proxy to QGIS server and which control which user can access to which projects in your application, depending on the authenticated user in the app. And finally, you have a service to generate configuration for all these services from a single JSON file. There are also some interesting features that have been implemented recently in the administration panel by SourcePol. It is a kind of plugin named Thames that helps you to configure all of your projects in the app with user interface. So it's quite easy to change some parameters in your application. I have also added the possibility to upload new QGIS projects and or files on the server with this interface. So now I can show you how it works in this video. So I have my application with already two projects in it. And I have configured a new project that I want in QGIS desktop that I want to add in my application. To do so, I have to go to the administration panel. So I need the administration role. Then I will go to the theme tab. And here you can see that there are already all the projects available in my application. So I can modify or delete some of them. And if I want to add a new project, a new QGIS project, I have to go to the upload file menu. And here are the QGIS projects and some layers already on the server. Now I select the Lyon Métropole .qgs to be uploaded on the server. So now I have to create a new theme configuration for this project. So I select this Lyon Métropole project and I can fill in some information in the form, such as a title, attribution, format, etc. And you can also add some search providers that are already configured in your application. For example, here I had base address national, which is a French service to find French addresses, and nominatim provider. Also, I can add a base map. Here I add CartoDB. And I set it by default visible. So I save this new theme configuration. And now when I go to the resources tab, I can see my Lyon Métropole project that is available. By default in my application, when I add a project, it is not visible if you are not logged in the application. So what I want to do is to have my Lyon Métropole project available for everybody. So to do this, I have to go to the permission tab and create a new permission for the public role and for my Lyon Métropole project. Okay, so I save this configuration. And now I just need to generate the configuration of all my services and wait a little bit. So I'm just waiting for the configuration to be generated. Here I see that it is successful. So now I can come back to the application, my QGIS client application. I refresh it and I can see my new project in the application. So I can select it to load to be loaded in the application, and I can use the search providers that I have configured in the configuration. And if I search for Place Bellecour, here I have the results for base address from base address national and results from nominative. So if I select one of these results, it brings me at the right location. And now I can see the data from my QGIS project with the layers. So it took me a couple of minutes to add my project to the application. So you can see that it is quite easy and quick to add a new project in a QGIS Web Client now. What is new in 2021, sorry. I have already told you that there were new features implemented in administration panel, such as a temp plugin by SourcePol. So now you can configure your projects with user interface. I have also added the possibility to upload QGIS projects and some layers such as GeoJSON, JFile, and GeoPackage, I think. I have created a kind of bookmark feature. So each user that are logged in the application can now save extant annotation or layers visibility in a bookmark. And the user can come back to these bookmarks whenever you want. For the 8 profiles, you can now export the profile to CSV files. And since 1 or 2 weeks, there is now a single entry point for the documentation of QGIS Web Client and all of its services, thanks to SourcePol again. So if you are interested in QGIS Web Client and you wonder how to use it and how to install all of its components, you can go to this link and follow the documentation and choose the features you want to have in your own application. And there are also more new features from this year that have been done by Auslandia, SourcePol, and other contributors that I didn't mention yet. So thanks to all of these contributors. Regarding the roadmap, as a QGIS Web Client is a community project, it is quite open and depends on the customer needs. But here are some ideas of features that will be nice to have in a QGIS Web Client, I think, such as attribute table. We can also enhance QGIS project publication. For instance, we can add more formats to be uploaded on the server. We can also add the possibility to upload SVG symbols, layouts. We can also improve automatic configuration to have all the possibilities of configuration directly in the user interface to avoid the administrator of the application to edit the JSON files directly. And also we could have some local features such as French cadastre and its features linked to this cadastre. Of course, you can also help the project to develop and improve by reporting issues, translating into your languages, or writing some source code. So pull requests are welcomed in these repositories. And you can also discuss about new features you would like to see by contacting us or writing to the mailing list to see if other people are interested in the same features as you. And maybe you could mutualize the funding. To finish, I have listed some example of QGIS Web Client application that you can browse to see all the features I have presented in this talk. So be free to go to this application if you want to know more about QGIS Web Client. And that's it. Thank you for listening. I don't know if I have 20 minutes. Yeah.
Thank you for the talk. That was super insightful. And indeed, it raised some very interesting questions. It brought some very interesting questions in the Venulus app. So buckle up. First question is, can you somehow implement QGIS processing tools as well inside a web app as an asynchronous task or a synchronous task?
To be honest, I don't know. I really don't know. Sorry.
No, don't worry about it. Thanks. Well, it's something to consider for the future, right?
Yeah.
So next voted question. Would you consider using the web client services to implement a geospatial WMS API with authentication?
I don't know if I understand the question. Maybe to connect to the WMS API. I don't think so. I really don't know.
Okay. Oh. And another question that has even more votes, I've just noticed. I'll just read the question out loud. Could we have an honest comparison between the Web Client 2 and LizMap? Well,
sorry, I'm not the right person to answer this question because I never used LizMap. But I think it's a good product too, but it's not the same technologies that are used. There was a presentation by René Luc Don of LizMap this morning, I think. Mm-hmm. I think you can try to install the two components. QGIS Web Client, the benefit of using QGIS Web Client is that it is very modular. You can do everything you want. If you don't want a server-side component, you can use it as it is. So I don't know, honestly. I don't have preference. I just use QGIS Web Client, so I would say QGIS Web Client, but I don't know LizMap.
You could be just a little bit, but just a little bit biased, right? Moving to next question, how you save the QGIS project?
First, you have to configure your QGIS project in QGIS desktop. Then the video I showed you shows the all the things you have to do to upload your QGIS project directly on the server in the right directory for QGIS server to read this project. Then I need to save each configuration I do in administration panel. And finally, you have to generate the configuration for all the services to take into account all your the modifications you did in the administration panel. So it's quite intuitive. You can watch again the video and see how I added the project.
Thank you. And time for one last question. WPS inside Web Client 2 possible?
It is not implemented yet. Maybe it could be a feature to implement, but I don't really know WPS, and I don't know how much work it represents. Mm-hmm.
So thank you very much. We'll leave just a few more minutes for people to change stages. And thank you for the presentation, for answering questions. You know, when you have such a mature, you know, and big open source ecosystem, questions like, is this better than this one, is almost unavoidable, but it's great. You know, it's wonderful. Yeah. We have a lot of options to choose from and to make better and to you know, to answer the questions in our work, in our everyday life, right? So thanks a lot. And I hope to see you in Italy next year, right?
Yeah.
Hopefully, physically, face-to-face event.
I hope to. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Okay.